Price Soccer Club was started in 2004. There was a great need for a more competitive soccer club in the area. There was many influential community leaders that helped start the club. From that point, we formed a few teams, and over the years, it's expanded into 30 teams. Playing at all age groups and competing at the highest levels.
A lot of people don't know about it and they're like, who is Pride? And then we go and we play well and they're like surprised.
I played rec soccer when I was a little kid in West Virginia. And then when I moved here, my parents kind of pushed me to play just like one sport so I could just focus on that. And Pride was the local team.
We're like a family almost. All coaches know each other. All the players know each other. They're very family oriented.
Pride Soccer Club is the recommended club by most area high school coaches. We have 11 high school age group teams with players from over 20 different high schools. In fall of 2014, we had over 50 players receive all league, all district, and all state honors.
First and foremost, the reason that we wanted to start Pride Soccer Club here is when I was playing as a young player in the area, and there weren't any clubs around. I had to travel 45, 50 minutes away to find the nearest club. In high school and college, there were a great deal of coaches who helped me develop my philosophy, instill for me a love for the game. And you know, we want to be a club that has coaches that do the same for young players. We've been fortunate to have several of the current Pride Soccer Club coaching staff were also players for Pride a number of years ago. It gives us great joy not only to develop the players in our club, but develop coaches as well.
My favorite coach, I would have to say, it would be Coach Casperson and Coach Woodruff. Coach Casperson, because he did start me with soccer, and he taught me so much, not only as a player, but as a person. Taught me how to respect the game, how to love the game, and just taught me life lessons.
Oh, Jeff Marks. By far, Jeff Marks is my favorite person. He's funny, he's good, he's great with the kids, he makes them work hard. He's just a great person to be around.
Jeff Marks came along, and he's just an outstanding guy and pushed me to like be an excellent person on and off the field. I had two knee surgeries in my career, and he, no matter what, would text me all the time and ask how I was doing. And then once I was finally able to recover, we would go like on off days, separate from trainings with the team, and he would just work one-on-one with me till I was healthy again.
What makes a good coach is first that they are excellent in what they do. They want to become better. They care for the player. They have the player's best interests in mind. They are passionate about the game. They understand how to communicate, how to teach. They're good leaders. The personality is important based on which age group they're going to be coaching. If they're going to be coaching a certain age group, we want to make sure that they fit into that age group and into that type of player.
The coaching staff, starting with Jeff, and continue with the people that are really involved with the club, Jeff Marks, Casperson, and Kreebaum, and all those guys are just great people. People that not just care about winning, but they care about the kids, they care about the community. They care about what they do, and they do it with love. And it shows on the field and off the field. And those kids are never in trouble. They're always polite. They play hard, because it's part of soccer. But the most important part is that they always, their demeanor on the field and off the field reflects what Pride had instilled in them as players.
Our coaching staff is tremendous and really focuses on developing and improving each and every player. We've seen players improve by their commitment to the Pride Soccer Club program in the fall, winter activities in the spring, our summer camps that they offered, really improved the player all year round in all the different skill sets. If it's futsal during the winter, if it's speed and agility camp during the winter, then playing at a very high level during the fall and spring season.
Ian Dotery's done a great job. Mark taught her a lot of the basics when she was young, and Ian's done a nice job here in the high school level. Ian's strength is tactical, and this our U17 team is one of the top teams in the state.
I've had a struggle with concussions and whatnot, and I've thought about quitting a couple times just because of concussions, but Coach Casperson always told me, never give up, you'll be all right. And he's given me the inspiration to move forward.
At Pride Soccer Club, we want every player to get better. We want them to reach their potential. For some, that might be just to be able to make their school team. For others, it might be to play in college or beyond. No matter what, we want to make sure that in their experience that they see improvement, they see development, not only them, but their family members, and they're able to take some pride in that, knowing that they made themselves better through their hard work.
I'm a current head coach at Bloom Carroll, and I coach the girls' soccer team there. I've also coached in the Mid-State League for Taze Valley on the boys' side. The Pride Soccer Club has raised the level of soccer in this area, and then we're seeing the benefits of these high school teams reaching new levels in the state tournament, with league championships and the honors of all these players. We've had multiple high school players receive Division I offers and other small college offers because of Pride Soccer Club's development, especially at a young age.
I've learned a lot. I had really, really good coaches. They knew a lot about soccer and formation. I developed like my skills and my techniques and like learned to play faster. I've thought less. It's more instinct now that we're older. We've like worked on the development when you're younger, and now he just expects us to play better, like better first touches, faster.
We had a player named Amy Anderson who currently plays for Wright State University. She came to Pride Soccer Club as a defender with little knowledge of the way to play the game. She had lots of athletic ability, but skills were still very raw. In a short amount of time, Amy developed into a dynamic forward at the high school level and even received a scholarship to play for Wright State University, a Division I college.
This is Amy Anderson for Wright State. Anderson tries to cross it. Shot by Fillion, and a goal for Wright State.
You know, I wanted to have a good experience, good soccer experience for the kids, but you know, it's gone beyond soccer. It went into, like I said before, friendship and community and community involvement and all the things that are really important for a community to do well and have a good future and have great kids and great families.
We've had a great experience for these last 9 years. Your child's team has the same coach for every practice and every game, so there's really good consistency during the season. And the second thing I like is, especially at the younger age groups, the focus is purely technical. They do a great job just developing the kids' foot skills, which is so important as they get older, because if they don't learn the foundation when they're young, it's very difficult to teach as they get older. As a young lady, she's gained a lot of confidence. I think through Pride, they give these young girls a lot of confidence, which is so important in their development. As far as soccer goes, her skill level is very, very good. She loves to compete. She has got a good skill level, and she's developed a lot of good friends through soccer.
What I've learned from Pride is that, like, well, with my team, like, there's really not a lot of clickiness between our players, and Ian keeps it pretty even, like, with everybody. And I've made a lot of new friends on the team, and like people that I've never thought I'd be friends with. Like, we have a lot of different kinds of people, and so I think I've become more open-minded to talking to more people who I don't think are like me at all.
Both my brothers play for the club. I'm one of three boys. As a family, playing travel soccer with three boys, I mean, we travel all the time. it's hard for our parents to make like all of our games just because we have three of us. But overall, I think the club does a good job like recognizing like individual families that have players like that. Like usually they'll try and work with our schedules so that my parents are able to take us to practices and games and be able to see us play.
We also want players to be able to do well off the field. We want players who are respectful, that understand responsibility, that are disciplined, that treat others with kindness and fairness.
My son started at U11. Fortunately for him, he's always been a pretty good soccer player. But you know, throughout the years, he's become a better soccer player. He's more resilient. He doesn't give up. He tries real hard. And now he's gonna be attending Cedarville University with a scholarship in soccer. Not only because of who he is on the field, but who he is off the field. And that, and pride has a lot to do with his development as a player and as a person.
Pride Soccer Club is more than just on the field.
Several years ago and throughout the years, many parents and players have donated soccer shoes and jerseys. And I was able to go on a trip to Nicaragua and deliver those shoes and jerseys to the players who love the game. They are very talented. They just don't have as much as we do here in the United States to be able to be a part of that and have Pride Soccer Club and its parents and players help. It's just a great experience.
I would love to come back and coach for Pride Soccer. If Jeff gave me the opportunity to have a team, I would love that. I love like the aspect of like teaching younger players.
I plan to play in college. Well, if I get offered, that'd be nice, but like, yeah. But I don't have a problem with being a walk-on either.
I do want to coach. I think like just being around sports, I can't just stop playing sports, and having such good coaches like Ian, and I had Mark Kasperson, and even when I was younger, I had really good coaches, and I thought it would be amazing if I could pass down what they taught to me to younger girls who want to play.
My experience with Pride has been one of the best experiences of my life. My kids have grown as not just as players, but as people, as individuals. The individual skills have grown tremendously, and the people skills are just unbelievable. If I had to do it over again, it would start. Actually, probably started earlier. As you can see now, he's going in college. He's gone and played 7 years in Pride. He's made great friends. It's been a great experience, and I would do it, no doubt about it.